I'm Bill and I'm 86 years old. I had start wearing hearing aids when I was 30. I went from 15% hearing loss to 90% hearing loss.
I'm Dr. William Slattery. I'm the president of House Clinic in Los Angeles, California. I'm a neurotologist. I do cochlear implants. I treat patients with hearing loss. My father's hearing loss started very early. So over the years, he tried different hearing aids and he really was no longer able to function with even the most powerful hearing aids.
He was so good at listening and turning his head that you really didn't pay attention to it.
Fortunately, most people don't have a sudden experience with hearing loss. Most of the time it comes in gradually for most individuals. And as a result of that, the family kind of just also gradually adapts to the hearing loss.
Everything I had to write out for him. We couldn't discuss anything without my writing. And that was very frustrating because I just wanted to talk to him at times.
She was what I like to call the enabler for him to be able to function as well as he could. I think the thing we enjoy doing the most is just having conversations about what's going on in our lives. That's part of what makes us human, is we want to bond with each other. We bond with communication, with conversation.
It wasn't until we had children that you begin to realize how much you want him to have the full complement of hearing when the kids are learning to talk or when they're saying his name, and for him not to be able to hear that is a loss.
That was very frustrating to me that you couldn't understand your own kids.
Unfortunately, the individual with the hearing loss is the worst judge of their own hearing. And so it does take someone else many times to say, you know what, you're really having more of a problem here than you think you are. We started the cochlear implant journey while I was still in medical school. I think my father struggled, you know, as many patients do, with, I know what I have now with my hearing aids. There's something that's potentially better, but what am I going to lose in order to gain something? So it took a couple years for him to get through that process. The fun part was I got to be there for his activation. So we're driving home, I'm driving, my father's in the front seat, my mom's in the back seat. So my mom says, well, I guess I can't talk behind his back anymore. And he turns around and says, you're right, you can't.
We got out of the car and he said, what is that? And it was the sound of the waves. He could hear the waves getting out of the car, which was just a very emotional moment for all of us.
I mean, we were crying. I cried a day about it. It turned our lives around. It really did.
I think that the speech and understanding people is the most important thing that I got out of it. It really is. It's a miracle.
For me as a physician, every time someone gets activated with a cochlear implant, I think about how are relationships being enhanced within their life. It helps basically bring people together the way we're meant to be by communicating with each other.